In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Merciful and compassionate Father, we come to you in our need to seek your protection against the COVID-19 virus that has disturbed and claimed lives. We ask you now to look upon us with love, and by your healing hand, dispel the fear of sickness and death, restore our hope, and strengthen our faith. We pray that you guide a people tasked to find cures for this disease and to stem its transmission. We thank you for the vaccines developed, made possible by your guiding hands. Bless our efforts to use these vaccines to end the pandemic in our country and the world. We pray for our health workers that they may minister to the sick with competence and compassion. Grant them health in mind and body, strength in their commitment, protection from the disease. We pray for those afflicted. May they be restored to health. Protect those who care for them. Grant eternal rest to those who have died. Give us the grace in these trying times to work for the good of all and to help those in need. May our concern and compassion for each other see us through this crisis and lead us to conversion and holiness. Grant all these through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever. Amen. We fly to your protection, O Holy Mother of God. Do not despise our petition in our necessities, but deliver us always from all dangers. O glorious and blessed Virgin. Amen. Our Lady Health of the Sick, pray for us. Saint Joseph, pray for us. Saint Raphael the Archangel, pray for us. San Roque, pray for us. San Lorenzo Ruiz, pray for us. San Pedro Calungsod, pray for us. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, Amen.
Welcome, brothers and sisters in Christ, to the celebration of the Holy Eucharist. Today is the 15th Sunday in Ordinary Time. Our priest presider is the Reverend Fr Mario Sobrejuanite of the Society of St. Paul, Superior of the Divine Master Retreat House in Ariccia, Italy, and Spiritual Director of the Acts Catholic Prayer Community. Let us join the Acts minstrels in singing the entrance hymn.
Welcome you to this, our celebration of gratefulness, of joy to the God who loves us all. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
My dear friends, Jesus sends the 12 out to preach and bring the good news to the people. This mission will be carried on not only by the direct successors of the apostles, the bishops, but also by all ordained ministers, religious men and women, and by every Christian who has been baptized, the lay people. By virtue of our baptism, we are all sent to bear witness to Christ in word and in deed. At the same time, we must receive God's messengers who preach repentance and announce the good news to us. For those times when we forget that all of us are actually evangelizers and have been called and are being sent to proclaim and establish the kingdom of justice and peace, we ask the Lord's forgiveness. God, have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Papuri sa Dios sa kahitaasan.
Papuri sa Dios. Papuri sa Diyos sa kaitaasan. Papuri sa Diyos at sa lupa'y kapayapaan sa mga taong kinalulugdan niya. Pinupuri ka namin, inalangan ka namin.
O God, who showed the light of your truth to those who go astray, so that they may return to the right path, give all who for the faith they profess are accounted Christians the grace to reject whatever is contrary to the name of Christ and to strive after all that does it honor. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen. The temple priest suspects Amos to be a professional who prophesies for gain. Amos replies that the Lord has chosen him, a shepherd, to bring his message to a people who wallow in pleasure and are deaf to the cries of the poor. The first reading.
A reading from the book of the prophet Amos. Amaziah, priest of Bethel, said to Amos, "Off with you, visionary, flee to the land of Judah. There earn your bread by prophesying, but never again prophesy in Bethel. For it is the king's sanctuary and a royal temple." Amos answered Amaziah, "I was no prophet, nor have I belonged to a company of prophets. I was a shepherd and a dresser of sycamores. The Lord took me from the following the flock and said to me, 'Go, prophesy to my people Israel.'" The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Oh, Lord, let us hear your voice.
sings a hymn of thanksgiving to God for the spiritual blessings given us in Christ, among which are holiness, goodness, wisdom, and love. We participate in God's plan for creation when we use our gifts for the benefit of all. The second reading.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Ephesians. Blessed be the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who has blessed us in Christ with every spiritual blessing in the heavens, as he chose us in him before the foundation of the world, to be holy and without blemish before him. In love, he destined us for adoption to himself through Jesus Christ, in accord with the favor of his will, for the praise of the glory of his grace that he granted us in the beloved. In him, we have redemption by his blood, the forgiveness of transgressions, in accord with the riches of his grace that he lavished upon us. In all wisdom and insight, he has made known to us the mystery of his will in accord with his favor, that he set forth in him as a plan for the fullness of times, to sum up all things in Christ, in heaven and on earth. In him we were also chosen, destined in accord with the purpose of the one who accomplishes all things according to the intentions of his will, so that we might exist for the praise of his glory, we who first hope in Christ. In him you also, who have heard the word of truth, the gospel of our salvation, and have believed in him, were sealed with the promised Holy Spirit, which is the first installment of our inheritance toward redemption as God's possession, to the praise of his glory. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Let us give honor to the Holy Gospel. May the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ enlighten the eyes of our hearts, that we may know what is the hope that belongs to our call. Alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
The proclamation from the Holy Gospel according to Saint Mark.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus summoned the 12 and began to send them out by two and gave them authority over unclean spirits. He instructed them to take nothing for the journey but a walking stick, no food, no sack, no money in their belts. They were, however, to wear sandals, but not a second tunic. He said to them, "Wherever you enter a house, stay there until you leave. Whatever place does not welcome you or listen to you, leave there and shake the dust off your feet in testimony against them." So they went off and preached repentance. The 12 drove out many demons, and they anointed with oil many who were sick and cured them. Sisters and brothers, the gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Ilang beses na natin sinasabi na may dalawang favorite phrases ang Lord. Actually, two words. The first is, go, or rather, come. Yun. Come and be my disciples. Come and see where I live. Come and get to find out what is in my heart. Come and learn as students before the teacher. Come and be my disciples as you consider me your master. Come. Pero mayroong ikalawa. Even as the Lord asks them to come, He sends them for a mission. Go. Go and make disciples of all nations. Go and baptize. Go and proclaim that the kingdom of God is at hand. Go and establish the kingdom of God on earth. Go. At today, may dalawa siyang basic instructions para sa kanila. The first is that they have to go two by two. May mga backgrounds po ito, firstly. Because if you're going to be a witness, hindi ka pwedeng maging witness na nag-iisa. You have to go with another. Two. Pangalawa, companionship. Kailangan mo na may kasama. Pangatlo, protection din yun. Even as they travel to places that is not known to them. Pangapat, syempre to encourage one another. In panglima, accountability. That you have to account to someone na kasama mo. The Lord understands the difficulties of being a missionary, of being an evangelizer. And He asked that you should go as a team, two by two, as you establish God's kingdom. Pero may another requirement that is masasabi mo, ha? Huh? Requirement ba talaga ito? He calls them and sends them, giving them authority. Pero this time, marami siyang bagay na sinasabing, huwag niyong dalhin. Mga bagay na inaasahan mo sa isang dapat may gagawin, may mission. Do not take money with you. Do not take a sack where you will place so many things. Do not take food with you. The only thing you bring with you is an extra sandal sapagkat mahabang lakaran to and an extra tunic. That's it. Masasabi mong the Lord is asking them not just to leave the things that are frivolous, ibig sabihin, hindi tunay na pangangailangan, but even the things that are essential. And we ask, Lord, okay lang ba tong requirements mo na to? In fact, His requirements do not just demand simplicity, but even go to the point of deprivation of things that are seemingly important. Kaya masabi mong it is not just simplicity, it goes beyond and it goes to reckless faith. They have to take the risk. They have to rely on the one who sends them, who will be accompanying them, and the one to whom they are going for the generosity ng kanilang mga pagsisilbihan. Sasabihin mo, parang hindi ganun ang estilo ngayon ng mundo. Ngayon, pag sinabi mong you're being sent to a mission, oy, may adequate preparation yan. May education about the culture. May sinasabing dapat piliin mo yung magaling. Alam niyo mga kapatid, pag tinignan mo yung mga apostles, magtataka ka, ito bang mga ito siyang dapat ipapadala? Because the moment He says, you go on a mission, He will demand from that person, hindi yung educated ka, may kilala ka, may pera ka, may connection ka, maraming nakakakilala sa'yo, marami kang supporters. No? All of these, wala sa mga pinili ng Panginoon. They were ordinary men. Men, sabi nga natin na, who did great things and accomplished great things for Christ despite of their simple men. I like this phrase every time. Sabi nga nila, the true humble person will shine not because of his greatness, but because the moment he truly is humble, God's light will shine through Him. Sasabihin mo, may mga cracks doon sa vase kung saan inilagay ang ilaw ng Panginoon. But that's okay. Because through those cracks, through your own brokenness, the light of the divine will shine through you. Gusto ko yun. In short, precisely because they are small, precisely because they are not prepared, precisely because they have no connections, precisely because they have nothing that they can rely on this world, they will have to rely more on God and in His promise and in His faithfulness. So much so that in the end, magiging clear sa mga taong pinagsisigan, hindi kayo naging successful dahil kayo. Kayo naging successful because God has worked through you. Mga kapatid, tingnan mo itong mga itong pinili ni Kristo. They were very simple men. Many of them uneducated. Pero worse than that, they are examples also of unfaithfulness, of fickleness. People, well, two of them will betray Him. These are the closest associates of the Lord. Others will leave. In a moment of crisis, no one will be left, hardly anyone except John. There will be moments of profound dispersal and indifference. They definitely are not perfect. Kung naghanap ka ng perfect sa mga apostles, please don't. They struggled to believe. There were moments when it was just too much for them. They were dispersed. They doubted. And unfortunately, they were super slow to understand. Nalala niyo mga moments na doon, says, hanggang ngayon ba, hindi pa rin kayo naniniwala sa kabila ng inyong nakita, even as you witness the many miracles and show of power that this carpenter of Nazareth has permitted you to see. That's the first. The second, no? The Lord sends people not because of their capacity, but because they truly believe that in Him they will be successful. And third, ang karakteristik nito, saan kayo ipapadala? Ay hindi to the great ones of Israel. Ay hindi to those who are known and popular and are governors and politicians. There are people who are supposedly in position of authority. Alam nyo, sabi niya, here is the third character. Go to the lost sheep. Ano yung lost sheep? Yung mga nasa periphery. Yung mga sinasabing unwanted. Those which society rejects. The marginalized. Those who are considered impure. Those who are considered do not belong. The ritually rejected ones. Yung mga wakay at mga wakay. Ito yung mga tao na dapat ninyong puntahan. Why? Because many times they were told, the Lord does not like you. You are out of His love. Tell them, if anyone tells them no one wants you, tell them, your God does, I do, sabi ni Lord. If people tell them they do not count, tell them for the Lord, they count. If there were others who will tell them, eh, hanggang dyan na lang kayo, you remain like that forever. Tell them, I have great plans for them. And if they feel that God has forgotten them, tell them, God so much remembers them who are poor. Kaya sa mga pinapadala, tatlong questions. No? First question is, are you willing to leave everything behind? Yung mga ideya mo, yung comfort zones mo, yung approval ng pamilya mo, your relationships on which you depend. Are you willing to leave all of this behind to take up a new relationship which is necessary for the building of the kingdom? Pangalawa, are you willing to bet all, to take the risk, to take the leap of faith, to take the jump into the unknown? Ang hirap sagutin noon sa isang leader. Why? Because this will tell me whether you truly trust me. This will tell me whether you can truly say, my God is greater than all of this. At pangatlo, are you ready to be free? Free in what sense? Free of your old concepts, free of your ambition, free of your desire to be looked upon, free even of your simple joys, because you will find your true joy only in the God who sends you. Mga kapatid, brothers and sisters, the Lord today asks of us to pray for these people. Pray not only for leaders in the church, but pray also for leaders in the world of politics. They will only be leader if they will have the passion that the Lord has for His people. Ito kwento lang ha. Kung wala tayong pinapatamaan, pero itong kwento, maraming tatamaan. Kasi na-discover ko lang, kasi pinadala sa akin, and afterwards, nag-research din po ako. They speak of the world's poorest president. Maybe the world should speak of the most humble head of state. Siya po, ng kabataan, has been an activist because he wanted to fight against the repressive military dictator ng kanyang bayan. He saw his people suffering and he decided to do something about it. He decided to even fight. Nang mahuli siya, he was tortured in jail, put in jail for 14 years, and there he suffered a lot. Nang umalis siya sa jail, medyo hindi maging maganda ang kanyang kondisyon, but he continued to work for his people. And then, sa dami ng mga nangyari, this farmer became president ng kanyang bayan. Ang kanyang pong bayan is Uruguay. Siya po'y naging presidente from the year 2010 hanggang the year 2015. Presidente ka na, ibahin mo na. But he decided that my becoming a president is not supposed to change my simple life. Number one, ayon yung tumira doon sa palasyo ng presidente na natili siyang tumira sa maliit na farmhouse na pag-aari nung kanyang napangasawa. He did not want to have a car, a presidential car. He continued to use his 1987 Volkswagen that costed him only $1,800. Nang maging presidente siya, may gustong bumili nung kanyang Volkswagen for $1 million. Sabi niya, kung mayroong bibili, yun idodonate ko para sa mga mahihirap. He had only two bodyguards. He did not want anything that is special. At alam mo, may puso talaga siya kasi ang kanyang aso, pati aso yung pinili, is a three-legged dog. May concern siya, halata mo. Ang pangalan po niya ay si Jose, or tawag din na si Pepe Mojica, the 40th president of Uruguay. Ay incredible yung kanyang focus on his mission. Yung kanyang passion for what he believed in. He would become the most popular leader and wanted to change the system, always putting the concern of his people above everyone else's concern, including his. Alam mo, simple lang ang angad niya. Can you imagine? Ito lang yun. He did not like to complicate life. He just wanted na there is going to be food at the table para sa mga mahihirap. There is going to be roof for those who need a home. There is going to be schools for those who would like to be educated. There is going to be water. Simpleng problema that has to be provided for his people. And then, in order to make this possible and to show them that he is really serious, 90% ng kanyang sweldo ibinigay sa mga mahihirap. And then, eto grabe ha, pakinggan niyo to ha. And while others wish to rule their country over and over again, this president, Jose Mojica, never wished to be re-elected.
Hindi siya naniniwala na siya lamang ang magaling. Nais niya na ang iba na may mapagbigyan. Hindi siya naniniwala na wala ng iba sa kanyang bayan na pwedeng mamunok. Alam niyo ang description niya? Kasi a president, sabi niya, is a high-level official who is elected for a function. He is not a king. He is not a god. Not my words sa kanya. He's not even a witch doctor of a tribe who knows everything. Hindi niya alam lahat. He is a civil servant. And as such, he must leave and be replaced. I am against re-election. Idudugtungan ko lang ha. Kasi tayo dapat marunong din tayong pumili. Oh, sabi nga ni Mahatma Gandhi, if a people elects an idiot for their leader, they are well represented. Idiot na pili nyo, idiot din kayo. Pero tignan mo ang resulta dahil sa mamang ito may ganong pagmamahal sa kanyang bayan. He left his office and relatively a healthy economy for his people and a social stability, yun ang maganda, social stability that became the envy of bigger nations around South America. Something that can only dream about. My dear friends, brothers and sisters, si Pepe Mojica, si Jose, will this President Mojica will say, I have a simple way of life and I don't have to change just because I am president. I earn more than I need, even if it is not enough, for which reason I share. Ganda, no? Yung ramdam niya na, I can be contented with little things. Ang problema ng mga leaders is many cannot anymore be contented. Feeling nila sila na may karapatan at yung iba'y wala na. Feeling nila sila yung may right and the others do not have it. In fact, nang walo, hindi na siya presidente and he got elected pa rin as senator kasi ayaw siyang paawalan ng mga tao. Alam nyo, yung kanyang pension, ibinigay din sa mahihirap. He was so loved by his people for his being down to earth at sapagkat ramdam nila that they understand them, that he understand them for what they are. They saw him as honest and authentic as a leader. Kaya itong tinatawag nilang poor president, eto mga kapatid, made people to be confident on politics and politicians. Uy, grabe yun. If only one leader can change our concept of politicians in politics, that is the greatest achievement one leader can ever have. Politicians, unfortunately, put themselves first before the people. And Pepe, Jose Pepe Mojica, is a good reminder that the essence of a true leader is to serve and not to be served. Alam mo, grabe ang recognition nitong mamang ito. Ha? Can you imagine this? He was given the awards of the highest that they could give by Paraguay, by Peru, by Mexico, by Ecuador, by Bosnia, Herzegovina, by Panama, by Argentina. Can you imagine that? Even people outside of his country recognize it. Why am I telling you this? Because mga kapatid, only he who recognizes that he is a leader because God decided him to be one. If only he has passion and true love for his people. Pagdasal po natin ang lahat ng mga pinuno, pati na ang mga nasa simbahan, that they should never forget that it is the Lord who must shine through the cracks, to their humbleness, to their simplicity, to their not being prepared. Because in the end, when people recognize the work of God through our own littleness, then we have established indeed his kingdom. And so we declare, I believe in one God,
the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages. God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
Let us now pray to the Heavenly Father that we may become faithful disciples as we take on God's call to love unconditionally. Let us pray. Lord of love, hear our prayer.
Lord of love, hear our prayer.
May the church, the people of God, become a family of disciples and one beacon of light who faithfully leads out the person of Christ, the one true light, we pray.
Lord of love, hear our prayer.
May all civil leaders and public servants become faithful disciples of Christ. May they faithfully accomplish the duties and responsibilities they have sworn to, we pray.
Lord of love, hear our prayer.
May you grant all of us gathered here today to face life's difficulties, the grace of holy endurance, and the will to remain faithful to you, we pray.
Lord of love, hear our prayer.
May the Almighty Father continue to protect our viewers, the homebound, and their families. And may the good Lord, through the powerful intercession of our Blessed Mother, grant all intentions and requests offered through this Mass, we pray.
Lord of love, hear our prayer.
May our beloved dead enter your heavenly glory, we pray.
Lord of love, hear our prayer.
Let us pray for the urgent concerns of our community and our personal intentions. We pray.
Lord of love, hear our prayer.
Heavenly Father, hear our heart's desire. May your will be done in our lives. May ourselves be configured to the person of Christ, the perfect disciple of the Father, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Thank you.
Pray, my dear friends, that your sacrifice and mine be made acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Look upon the offerings of your church, O Lord, as she makes her prayer to you, and grant that when consumed by those who believe, they may bring ever greater holiness through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For when your children were scattered afar by sin, to the blood of your Son and the power of the Holy Spirit, you gathered them again to yourself, that the people formed as one by the unity of the Trinity, made the body of Christ and the temple of the Holy Spirit, might to the praise of your manifold wisdom be manifest as the church. And so in company with choir, the choirs of angels, we praise you and we joy, we proclaim.
Santo, 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 Panginoon Diyos sa kapangyarihan, na puno ang langit at lupa na kalagayan mo.
Indeed, holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the blood and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, with our cardinals and bishops and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you to your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, Almighty Father, forever and ever. Saint Paul would tell us that I take pride in my weakness, because when I am weak, then I am strong. I am strong with the strength of the divine. I am strong because he loves me and he sends me despite of who I am. We pray now for the establishment of God's kingdom on earth as it is in heaven. We pray thee, our Father. Deliver us, Lord, from every evil and grant us peace in our day. In your mercy, keep us free from sin and protect us from all anxiety as we wait in joyful hope for the coming of our Savior, Jesus the Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, I leave you my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and grant us the peace and unity of your kingdom, where you live forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
When we have God with us, there is nothing to be afraid of. Then he gives us his peace. We share that peace with one another. Peace be with you. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Happy are we who are called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Let us together pray this prayer for spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the Most Holy Sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
Let us pray. Having consumed these gifts, we pray, Lord, that by our participation in this mystery, its saving effects upon us may grow through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Meron po tayong announcement.
Are you exhausted? Bored? Fed up with a long period of isolation due to the pandemic? Are you feeling less and less hopeful? Well, we are here to bring you good news. The ACTS Catholic Prayer Community will have its first Zoom-in Jesus Encounter Seminar on July 18 to 29. We wish to invite you, your family, friends, and relatives, both here and abroad, to this event. This year's Jesus Encounter is aptly titled GCQ, God's Crucial Questions. Find out the answers to these to the essential questions of life through a special encounter with the Lord. We are blessed to have with us Fr Mario Sobrejuanite, Fr Domi Guzman, Brother Vic Pestaño, and Brother Obet Cabrillas as our speakers in this series. Please visit our Facebook page, actsprayer.com, to find out the schedule of our free Zoom-in Jesus Encounter Seminar and pre-register. We hope to be part of your life-changing journey with Christ. Thank you and God bless.
Ito po'y napakagandang opportunity ngayon namin po gagawin, but it could be a beautiful invitation para sa inyo who are looking for answers to what we are going through. I've always said this in the past, at maganda pong sabihin to, hindi yung tanong mo kung, Lord, why? Bakit nangyayari to? Maybe the question should be, what is your message, Lord, na dapat naming maintindihan in order for us to go on with life, knowing we are loved by you. Marapin pong series ang talks na gagawin iyan every Sunday po. And it's for free. If you are truly interested to find out something about what God may be telling you, ito po'y napagandang opportunity. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Bow your heads down and pray for God's blessing. May the God of consolation order your days in his peace and grant you the gifts of his blessing.
Amen.
May he free you always from every distress and confirm your hearts in his love.
Amen.
So that on this life's journey, you may be effective in good works, rich in the gifts of hope, faith, and charity, and may come happily to eternal life.
Amen.
And may the blessing of Almighty God come upon you and remain with you always. The Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
We have been blessed. Let's go on and continue to be God's blessings for others.
Thanks be to God.
Salamat po sa mga sumusuporta, sa mga nagtatrabaho, sa mga magpapadala ng kanilang mga intentions at kanilang mga comments. We welcome all of these and we are grateful for all of your generous contributions as well. Ingat po. God bless. The Mass is ended.
We stand.